world is yours. The world is yours.
It's mine, it's mine, it's mine. Whose world is this?
It's yours.
It's mine, it's mine, it's mine. Whose world is this?
The world is yours. The world is yours.
It's mine, it's mine, it's mine. Whose
I sip the dumb peak, watching Gandhi till I'm charged and writing in my book. The whole of mic, I'm throbbing. Mechanical movement, understandable smooth shit that murderers move with. The thief's theme, the thief's play theme. Me at night, they won't act right.
It's day two of our adventure in the Carolinas. Today, we're headed out to Blue Ridge Parkway in search of a place to take a short hike. After about 30 minutes of travel up the rainy, windy, and foggy parkway, we finally made our way to the Frying Pan Lookout Trail. At about 1.5 miles round trip down a gravel trail, this hike is considered moderate to most people. And at the end of the trail sits the historic 70-foot-tall Frying Pan Mountain Lookout Tower.
Yeah, I'm in rough shape, so if you're breathing real hard. But yeah, we're on currently on the Frying Pan Lookout Trail, something of that nature. It's about a mile and a half up, or a mile and a half round trip. Pretty foggy day, you know, it's early October, it's rainy, visibility's pretty low, but I think we can still catch a pretty cool view up there.
Constructed in 1940 by the U.S. Forest Service, this lookout tower offers stunning views of the surrounding mountains and valleys down below. From the summit of Frying Pan Lookout Tower, you can even catch in views of Mount Pisgah, Looking Glass Rock, and Cold Mountain. Today, however, that was not the case.
Well, so far, can't see anything, so I'll probably avoid going all the way to the top today. But hey, you get a little bit of foliage. Hey, everybody likes foliage.
Foliage.
Hey, everybody likes foliage or foliage, however the hell you say it.
Foliage.
Oh, I know. I'm working on my pronunciation. But hey, we made it this far, so on to the next trail.
This is my first time being in North Carolina during the fall season. Although I didn't catch the view that I wanted, it still didn't deter us from checking out all the amazing views from the overlooks on the way down. Later that day, we made our way out to Asheville and checked in to Bon Paul and Sharky's Hostel. I didn't get to stay here on my last trip, so I'm pretty excited to be back here in this part of town. We booked a private room for about $80 a night, which is pretty good considering the part of town that we're in. It's a Sunday night. And after we were done checking in and getting settled into our hotel, we made our way over to the closest pub that was open, called Westville Pub. We came here to have a few drinks and to watch some football. One of my favorite things to do while traveling to a new city is to check out some of the local dive bars, especially when there's food involved. After enjoying some great dinner and football, we opted to call it an early night so we could be up bright and early for our next adventure. Stay tuned.